In this section, we are going to cover the second mandatory check that needs to be performed, which is known as local failure analysis. The local failure analysis can be performed in two different approaches. The first one is elastic analysis and second is elastic plastic analysis. In this session, we'll be covering the elastic analysis. Let's first understand what does the local failure check does. As compared to the plastic collapse check, which considers total failure of the cross section, the local failure checks the stress distribution at every point of the model and sees to it that the stress distribution at any point as compared to at any section is within the allowable limits. So for example, if we are considering nozzle to shell junction, in plastic collapse check, you will consider failure at an entire section. So if this is the geometry of nozzle to head junction, you will consider failure of a complete cross section in plastic collapse check. Whereas in case of local failure check, you will be checking failure initiation, possibility of failure initiation at various points. So it is point versus section when we are doing at the local failure check. As said earlier, there is an elastic analysis, which is an approximate method, and more accurate method is elastic plastic analysis. We'll be covering elastic analysis approach of local failure check in this session. This particular check has got a relatively simple condition to be satisfied, that is at every point of the model, you have to see that the sum of the three principal stresses is less than 4 times the basic allowable stress, where S is the basic allowable stress. One point to be noted, the principal stresses that we are talking here, they are consisting of local primary membrane and bending stresses. So there is no peak stress is considered in this particular analysis. In order to obtain the summation of principal stresses corresponding to membrane and bending, one would have to write a short script or a program in ANSYS or whatever software you are using. And then you can directly plot the contour of the summation of principal stresses at every point. You have to check that at any point or the highest value of this principal stresses is within 4 times basic stresses. So for example, in the problem that we have solved earlier using plastic collapse, for the same problem, the 4 times allowable stress is 642.6, and the highest value of the summation of principal stress, as can be seen here, is 536.3 MPa, which is smaller than what is allowed. So this particular geometry satisfies the requirement of local failure check.